Hey there, handsome.
Hi there.
Joe ain't here right now. He said for you to meet him for lunch at Freddy's.
I see.
Too bad you were passed out when I came in. We could have partied. Maybe next time, doll. Bye.
Huh. That was something.
Broad, get the hell back here! If you can't drive, you should stay home where you belong!
Hey, isn't that Joe's girl over there? Well, one of them anyway.
You smacked up my car, I'm gonna smack up yours! Look at my fucking car!
Hey, pal, knock it off.
And who the fuck are you?
Somebody who doesn't like hearing you talk to a lady like that. So why don't you shut the fuck up and leave while I'm still in a good mood, huh?
What, is she your girlfriend or something? Well, if she's not gonna pay for it, you will.
One more word, and you're gonna need a new set of teeth. Now get the fuck out of here. That was the word.
Thanks, handsome. I owe you one. Do you want to come over to my place for a piece of pie?
Yeah, thanks, but look, I really gotta get going.
You'll like it, I promise. I gotta get going now. I'll see you around.
Hey, fellas.
Hey! Hey, Vito, this is Luca Garino. He'd like to talk to you and Joe. Luca, this is Vito.
Good to meet you, Mr. Garino.
No need to be so formal. Call me Luca. Take a seat, Vito.
What can I get you?
Same thing I'm having. And hurry it up. I heard about you running with the mix. Great fucking story. And I want to congratulate you, too, on a job well done. Salute.
A salute.
You guys did a hell of a job. Not too many guys got the stomach for this line of work. So now, I'm wondering if yous are ready to take the next step.
Yeah, sure.
What next step?
I'm talking about taking somebody out. Just because someone points his finger at him and tells you to do it.
I was in the war, Mr. Guarino. All I did was kill people I was told to kill. People the president pointed his finger at.
That's good. The president. Yeah, I like that. But you're talking about the Krauts, right? You know, the bad guys. That's not what I mean. Understand?
Yeah, I understand.
Good. We need guys like you. Guys who can follow orders without asking questions. You handle this next job like you handled the last one, and there's a good chance you'll be accepted into the family. After you pay the initiation fee, of course.
And how much is that?
$5,000 apiece.
That's a fucking fortune.
Hey, nobody said it was cheap, huh? But trust me, the benefits far outweigh the cost. I'll leave it up to you two to decide. Henry's gonna fill you in on the rest. I'll see his guys later.
There you are.
Hey, your boss.
You take care of that thing we talked about yet?
Yeah, it's all under control.
That's what you said the last time. Don't disappoint me again.
Boss,
Now come with me. We got some other business to discuss.
So, Henry, what kind of job we talking about here?
I gotta take a guy out. It's my contract, but thanks. I need some help. That's where you two come in.
Who's the lucky guy?
Some fat fuck from across the river. The guy's been warned, but he thinks he's untouchable.
And is he?
Well, somebody tried to take him out once before.
And?
Let's just say they slightly underestimated him.
How much is slightly?
Fatally.
That's a fancy way of saying they're dead, right?
Hey, they fucked up. We won't. I rented an apartment across the street from his business. We'll sit there, and we'll wait till that fat fuck shows up, and then boom! We blast his ass.
How are we gonna do that?
With an MG-42.
Where are we getting an MG-42 from?
Harry.
Yeah.
He's a vet, like you. He's got a private little gun shop over in Kingston. You can get your anything from a pea shooter to a bazooka. And you don't need no fucking gun license, neither.
Okay, Joe and me will go to the apartment. You go pick up the machine gun at Harry's shop in Kingston. It's all paid for. Just tell him I sent you. After that, meet us at the apartment. It's in Sand Island, the building across from the distillery. Apartment 233.
Okay, apartment 233. Got it. I'll meet you fellas there in a bit.
All right, I'll see you later.
Good luck, pal.
So long, buddy.
There's gonna be a hallelujah day when the boys have all come home to stay and the million bands begin to play. We'll be dancing the victory. And when we've lit the torch of liberty in each blacked-out land across the sea, when a man can proudly say I'm free, we'll be dancing the victory polka.
And we will give a mighty cheer when the ration book is just a souvenir. And we'll heave a mighty kiss goodbye.
And they'll come marching down Fifth Avenue the United Nations in review. When this lovely dream has all come true, we'll be dancing.
Who's there?
Henry Tomasino sent me to pick up the stuff he ordered.
Come on in. Yeah, what's up?
Henry Tomasino sent me to pick up the stuff he ordered.
Okay, come in.
Hello?
So, you're the guy Henry was telling me about, huh?
Yeah. You got his merchandise.
Yeah, well, here it is. MG-42, made in Germany. Hitler's buzzsaw, we call them. She's a beauty. 25 pounds. 7.92 caliber. 1,200 rounds per minute. Fastest in the world. 250 round belt, 3/4 mile effective range, and extremely reliable. I don't know what the hell you're hunting, but unless it's in a fucking tank, sayonara, baby. Hey, you need me to show you how to use it?
No, thanks. I'm familiar with him. I was in the service, too.
No shit! Wait, you're kidding me. Where were you? What was it, Normandy, huh? No, Africa? Let me guess.
Operation Husky.
Yeah? What unit were you in?
504th Parachute.
No shit, you were a paratrooper? That was kind of hairy, I heard.
Yeah, well, it wasn't no picnic, I tell you. I got hit, so they sent me home.
Yeah, any medals?
Yeah, Purple Heart and a DSC.
Whoa, wait, you got a cross? Let me tell you, they don't give those babies out for nothing. I was in Normandy. We hit Utah Beach. Yeah, that wasn't no picnic neither, but... When I was crawling over the fence on the way back, I poked my eye out on a fucking tree branch. Well, hey, it was good enough for a discharge.
Look, guy, I really gotta get going.
All right. Hey, by the way, I'm Harry.
Hey, Vito.
Hey, good to meet you, Vito. Real good. If you ever need some hardware, you know where to find me. There you go. I hope you drove here. She's a big girl. Good luck.
Hey, thanks. Nice to meet you, Harry.
The gun's in the crate, and there's a couple thousand rounds in the van out in the yard. Take it. It's all paid for. Hey, be careful.
Oh!
buddy.
Where are you from, Henry?
Sicily.
What brought you to the States?
Mussolini.
Will you buy your ticket?
Don't be a smartass, Joe. My father was a man of honor. Things got pretty bad for us after Mussolini came into power. My old man figured I'd either get drafted or locked up. So he sent me to America and got me a job working for Clementi.
So what happened to your father?
He said he was too old to make the trip. Mussolini had him arrested, and he died in jail. They won't even turn his body over for a proper burial.
That's rough.
So how's your English so good?
They're coming! Those black cars! Vito, aim for the fat bastard. We gotta nail him before he gets in the building. Get ready.
All right, I'm on it.
They got
All
guns.
Right, showtime.
They got guns up there in that window.
That's him, Vito. Waste that here.
We got them all. Stop shooting that fucking thing or don't get from over here. My sister. You okay? We'll get him. shooting that fucking thing! I'm going deaf over here!
Move it, Vito! We can't let that fat bastard get away.
Okay, you first, Vito. You're the fucking war hero.
Go, go, we're coming. Coming for you, Porky!
Going in!
All right, showtime, Vito.
You better kill this fucking guy before we run out of
room. Okay, we'll get him.
Come on, asshole.
Fuck!
What the fuck was that?
God damn it, now this whole fucking place is gonna burn to the ground. What a waste of bullets. Vito, come on, huh? We gotta move. Back me up, Vito. Oh no! No! Stay sharp, Vito.
Come on, no!
Okay, hit the button, Vito.
What the hell are you doing, Joe?
What? Thirsty. Pretty good stuff. You should try it.
Drinking on the job, huh? When'd you turn Irish?
Shit, there's an army of them! Vito, yo, do something! Can't just fucking sit here!
What the fuck do you expect me to do? They're shooting at me, for Christ's sakes! Vito, do something! You're the expert here! Alright, showtime, Vito. Is that the fucking best you got?
Move it, Vito! We can't let that fat bastard get away.
Okay, you first, Vito. You're the fucking war hero.
Go, go, we're
coming. Coming for you, Porky! Back me up, Vito! Oh, fuck! Watch out! Back me up, Vito!
What the fuck is that?
Die, you rat bastard! God damn it, now this whole fucking place is gonna burn to the ground! What a waste of Vito! Come on, huh? We gotta move! Going in!
Okay,
Hit the button, Vito.
What the hell are you doing, Joe?
What? Thirsty. Pretty good stuff. We should try it.
Drinking on the job, huh? When'd you turn Irish?
Sends his regards. Oh, fuck!
fuck you! Sorry, you
fuck.
Henry, you okay? Where'd he hit you?
Of course I'm not fucking okay. He shot me in the fucking leg.
Oh, yeah, it's bleeding all over.
Son of a... Get me to El Greco.
The fucking painter?
No, the fucking doctor,
okay, okay,
you idiot.
Take it easy. We're gonna get you there in a minute.
The Greek guy lives up in Highbrook.
All right, let's get you to the car.
Oh, Maradona, you're heavier than you look.
Fat fuck. He almost shot my balls off.
Take it easy. You missed him by a mile.
Hey, careful! This fucking hurts.
No.
Yeah, well,
please.
You can walk if you don't,
don't want to
get
die.
Moaning.
Hey, you're right. I don't need to get pissy. I'm the one bleeding to death here.
Oh. Fuck. This whole fucking place is coming apart.
Not Dago!
Fat fuck. He shot my balls off.
Take it easy. You missed him by a mile.
Hey, careful. This fucking hurts.
Yeah, well, you can walk if you don't quit. You're moaning.
I don't want to die.
This whole fucking place is coming apart.
You better kill this fucking guy before we run out of bullets.
Fat fuck. He almost shot my balls off.
Take it easy. You missed him by a mile.
Hey, careful. This fucking hurts.
Yeah, well, you can walk if you don't quit your moaning.
No.
Please.
I don't want to die.
Fuck. This whole fucking place is coming apart.
friend.
Jinx, what do you mean, you lucky bastard?
Oh, damn.
Saying that, pal, it's just a scratch. The doc will give you a few stitches and we'll all go out and celebrate.
No, really.
Shh, shouldn't talk right now. Helps conserve your strength. I've seen that in a movie once.
Yeah? What happened to the guy in the movie?
In pursuit of our suspect, we're taking him down.
Jesus, you drive like my fucking grandma.
Copy that.
Enough.
Just relax, would you?
I got a hole in my leg the size of a fucking golf ball, and you're telling me to relax? Just get me to El Greco, damn it.
So, fellas, who is this guy?
What guy?
This guy, Pagan Hennington.
El Greco? He's a doctor. Throw him a couple of bucks, he patches you up. No questions asked.
He's the guy you go see when you can't go to the hospital, genius.
Why the hell wouldn't you be able to go to the hospital?
Because you go to the hospital with a bullet in you, first thing they do is call the cops.
Yeah. So El Greco deals with a lot of guys in our line of work.
You shouldn't need to visit him, though, Vito. You've always been a quick healer. It must be your diet. Henry, you awake? Stay with me now.
Yeah.
Just hang in there, pal. We'll be at El Greco's in a minute. I can smell the souvlaki from here. Vito, there. That house. Park right in front.
You El Greco, the doctor?
No. I'm the fucking painter.
A friend needs help, or he's gonna bleed to death.
Thanks, Doc.
Good God, Henry.
We owe you one.
Get him inside. Hello, though.
Wait. I got money for you. For the job. Take it.
You know, this could have waited. But thanks.
And hey, thanks for everything.
I hope you'll be okay.
Yeah. Me too.
I'll stay here with Henry. Meet me at my place.
All right.
We apologize for interrupting the music, folks, but
We at ECNR have an important breaking news item. We are getting reports of a large-scale shootout at a Sand Island liquor distillery. Further information is unavailable at this time, ladies and gentlemen, as police cannot examine the scene due to the large fire that has consumed much of the building. More information as it comes. ECNR. And now, back to the music.
He's a maniac! We gotta take him down! Copy that.
If you like what you see, let me know.
At a distillery in Sand Island. And to make matters worse, the distillery is now completely engulfed in flames after the shootout earlier today.
Will that be all?
To your favorite music on Empire Classic Radio. I am Bob Barrowman.
Enjoy.
Oh, what am I, invisible?
Wanted to give you the money to pay off Papa's debt.
Oh, Vito, that's great. I was gonna try and see if we could pay it back in installments. I got a little money. He wouldn't have hurt us.
Don't be so sure, but it doesn't matter now. Here, take
where'd you get all this money, Vito? You haven't done nothing you'll be sorry for, have you?
Don't worry. Everything's fine.
Thank you, Vito. Thank you.
No problem. All right, look, I better be going. I don't want Ma to see me. She'll be asking where I got the money, too.
Don't worry. I'll make something up.
All right. Give her a big kiss for me,
will.
Okay?
Take care of yourself, Vito.
Vito Scaletta?
Yeah? What's it to you?
You're under arrest for the illegal distribution of federal ration stamps. You're coming with us.
One of the gas station attendants ratted me out. The guy fingered me and they strung our mama into telling him where I was staying. But they had no idea who I was working for, and I wasn't about to tell them. Henry was able to get me a lawyer, courtesy of his boss, Clemente. I was up Schitt's Creek, but at least I had a battle. Could have been a hell of a lot worse if the feds knew about any of my other activities.
To be even more serious, considering the fact that you stole national resources at a time when our country needs them the most. An act the gravity of which you, Mr. Scaletta...
The guy was good, but even he couldn't get me out of this one. It was a lost cause from day one. 3 months later, they handed down the verdict.
Vittorio Antonio Scaletta, for your crimes against the people of this city and of this great country, this court hereby sentences you to 10 years in a federal penitentiary.
Murderers, child molesters, they're all here. The worst of the worst.
All right, get in line, gentlemen. Follow me single file. And no monkey business, or else.
You want to make problems, you son of a bitch?
I'm sorry.
What's the matter? No speaking to English? Here, let me teach you. What, do you enjoy this, you sick fuck? Now, get your ass up and get back in line.
No.
Go. Hey, smartass, don't make me repeat myself. Back in line. Move it!
Stop right there. Turn to your right. Your other right.
Listen up, assholes. My name is Captain Terrence Stone, and this is my prison. You're here on the inside because you can't behave like normal human beings on the outside. Make no mistake, your ass belongs to me now, and you'll do what I say, or you'll be sorry that you did it! Fuck with me, and I'll fuck with your sorry ass all day long! You were sent here to be rehabilitated, and rehabilitate you, we will.
Okay, you assholes, we're gonna cut you loose just long enough to get yous cleaned up. Now get in line and follow me.
Welcome to the salon, ladies. You're gonna look just fucking beautiful.
Hey, me too? I ain't got nothing on my head to cut.
Shut your face, cue ball. Okay, let's go. Hey, shit for brains. Do what you fucking told.
Listen, Freddy boy, if you ain't gonna do what you're told, we're gonna stick you in the hole. Are you trying to piss me off? You wanna make problems, you son of a bitch? I can beat your ass six ways to Sunday, and ain't nobody gonna stop me. Move it! Usually you assholes figure out how this works, but you must
follow
be some
me.
Kind of retard.
Smell you new fish, and you smell good.
Welcome home. Get in.
Lights out! And be quiet, assholes! You know what's good for you.
This was gonna be my new home for the next 10 years. Looked like shit and smelled like piss. I would've preferred dodging bullets in Europe to this. After three action-packed days of staring at the wall, I got a message from Joe to contact a guy named Leo Galante, who could supposedly help me out in here. This wasn't the kind of place where you could survive on your own. I'm looking for Leo Galante.
Buzz off, asshole.
I'm looking for Leo Galante. You know where I can find him?
Never heard of him. Yo, why don't you shut the fuck up and get stepping?
I'm looking for Leo Galante.
Leave me the fuck alone.
Burning, ain't they? They don't no seem to shame friendly.
In
I'm looking for Leo Galante.
Hey, buddy,
beat it.
26 days. I have to survive 1,876 more days.
Hey, I need to talk to Leo Galante. Point them out, will you?
Get the fuck out my face, white bread.
I'm looking for Leo Galante.
Hey, buddy, beat it.
I'm looking for Leo Galante.
Never.
They got him in the shower.
They don't seem too friendly.
Yeah, those fucking queers are getting out.
I'm looking for Leo Galante.
Go bother somebody else.
Would they rip his rear end open or something?
No. I
have to survive 1,876 more days in this shithole until I...
Those arms burning, ain't they?
He's in the hall.
Hey, I need to talk to Leo Galante. Point them out, will you?
Don't ring a bell. Sorry.
You make you deal. You teach me basketball.
Excuse me, you know where Leo Galante is?
No good speaking to White Devil. You go away now.
I know you.
You're that fucking guinea who was with Barbara in the jewelry store. I'm in this fucking hellhole because of you.
You got locked up because you're a stupid, crazy fuck.
You know, fellas, my mom was right. There is a God! And he sent you here, you guinea bastard, so that I could pay you back!
This looks interesting. Want to make a small bet?
Stop this fucking rain!
You and your boyfriend Barbara are dead!
This is gonna be easier than the time I shoved the potato up your mother's ass.
Kick his teeth in!
Why eat skinny little faggots like you for breakfast?
You eat faggots for breakfast? Could you hear me?
Break it
Get
out.
Out of here!
Both of you should go into the hole!
We're gonna give you a little time to think about what you've done. Close it up.
So O'Neill almost took my head off, but I made a stand. Let me tell you something, when you're inside, counts for a lot more than you might think.
How long are you planning on keeping him in here?
Long enough to learn his lesson.
That's gonna have to change. He in any shape to fight?
Should be. Boys didn't knock him around too bad after the brawl in the yard. All right, open it up. Rise and shine, Scaletta. You got yourself a visitor.
My name is Leo Galante. I heard you wanted to speak to me.
Yeah. One of Clemente's guys said I should contact you. Said maybe you could help me out.
Oh, fuck Clemente. I don't provide protection for his guys in here. But I saw how you handled that Mick who's after you. O'Neill. He could prove useful. Come with me, boy. Now listen up, fellows. This is Vito. He's gonna be helping us out. Pepe here's got a big fight coming up. Against O'Neill. He needs a sparring partner. And from what I saw of you out there in the yard, you're just the man for the job. You're gonna help us out, kid. In return, you'll be under my protection. And who knows, maybe you'll even learn a thing or two along the way.
I guess I can't say no to that offer, huh?
I don't remember asking. All right, fellas. Let's get this show on the road. Okay, today we're gonna work on your counterpunching. Vito, I want you to hit Pepe. Try and bust that big jaw of his. Pepe, you avoid the punch like I showed you. Then use that momentum to throw a punch of your own. All right, fellas. Let's get going. Attaboy, Pepe. Keep that oversized chin of yours down, damn it. Whoa! Would you look at that?
Hey! We supposed to be sparring or training?
Change of plans, big fella. This kid's got fire in him. So now you're both gonna practice your counter punches. All right, Vito. See if you can do that again. It's a handy tool to have in a box, huh? Most guys ain't gonna see it coming. Pepe here, he ain't most guys, though.
Nice one.
Nice, kid, nice.
Shit, that hurt.
All right, one more, Vito. There you go. You're a fast learner, kid. All right, fellas, that's enough for today. Nice work. So how close did you get to Clemente, Vito?
Actually, I never met him. I always dealt with either Henry Tomasino or Luca Guarino.
Huh. I can't believe that cocksucker Guarino's still breathing.
What was your deal with him?
Well, you know, we did a couple jobs for him, and, Luca said he'd bring us into the family for, $5,000.
What? Typical fucking Alberto. He's always been a crooked bastard.
So what is that, like more than usual?
Yeah, like $5,000 more than usual.
You don't gotta pay to get in, Vito. You're brought into the family once you prove that you're loyal, a good earner. And he can handle, you know, the life. In any case, this is an interesting piece of news. When this gets out, Alberto and Luca are gonna have a lot of explaining to do.
To who?
Jeez.
Don't worry about that. We'll talk about it some other time.
Come on. Give me another 20.
Nice work in the ring, buddy. A little more of that and you'll be ready for a real fight.
Yeah, that's it.
Hey, how's it going?
How you doing, Vito? Name's Sal. Hey, nice work in the ring.
Keep it up.
Hey, how you doing? Name's Vito.
Yeah, I know. Name's Al. Good to meet you.
Winston's offering 2-1 against Pepe. Pepe wasn't a friend of mine. I take that bet. O'Neill's a fucking animal.
Yeah, that's it.
Watch where you walk, Guaylo.
Maybe if your eyes were all the way open, you would have seen me coming, asshole.
Galante. Crooked white devil.
Nice to see you too, Mr. Wu. Crooked? You bet on your own guy and he lost. That's the way it works in this country.
Then Wu offer you a rematch.
I think I can arrange that. You up to it, Vito?
Chinaman, huh? Yeah, get him a stepladder and send him over.
All right, Wu. Looks like you got yourself a rematch. And none of that chop suey crap this time. Now listen, these chinks are quick little bastards. No point in throwing big punches early on. You'll never connect.
All right. What am I supposed to do then?
You hit him quick and tire him out. When he's weak, he'll put his guard down. Then you swing for the fences. Now get out there and show him what you're made of.
Hey, does Vito get a fortune cookie after eating your guy for breakfast?
This no happen if you use tiger style.
Let's go, Scaletta. You're late for work.
Hey, listen. Vito here's got the day off, courtesy of Mr. Galante.
Gotcha. Don't get used to it, Scaletta.
All right. Come with me, Vito.
What, are we gonna train some more?
Sorta. You'll see.
Morning, kid.
Morning, Mr. Galante. Why, no training today?
Not exactly. We got a challenge from the Spooks, and I don't want to risk Pepe getting all banged up before his big fight with O'Neill. So I want you to take this one. It'll be good practice for you. Come on. Now, the guy you're going to be fighting is a strong bastard, but he ain't too bright. Fights with his heart, not his head. You piss him off, you lower his guard. That's when you let him have it. All right, here we go. Make me proud, kid.
Ooh, looky here. I'ma take this skinny-ass white boy to school. Gonna hit him so hard his mama's mama gonna feel it. Hope you meatballs getting ready to lose.
Hey, if it'll lose, it'll probably be the hardest work this bum ever did in his life.
Oh, come on, my grandmama hit me harder than that. Your little cracker going down!
Let's go, Vito! Put these bums back in their place!
Oh, this boy got as much chance of winning as a brother running for president.
Laying down on a job like that!
No! Finish. Now's your chance, kid. Knock him in the next one.
Don't worry, Vito. You got him right where you want him.
Hell of a job, kid. Hell of a job. Here's your cut, Vito. You earned it.
Yo, one of the hacks is coming.
What the hell is this? Some kind of circle jerk?
All right, come on, Scaletta. You got a visit. Hey, what's the holdup?
Hi, Vito.
Hey, Frankie. How you doing?
I'm doing good. Real good, thanks.
So, how's things?
Well, I got something to tell you. I'm getting married, Vito.
Oh, Maron, that's great. I mean, it would have been nice if he asked my permission first, but... Hey, I'm happy for you.
Vito, you're in jail. Look at yourself. How'd you let this happen?
Hey, I already got a lecture from the judge, huh? I don't need another one. Just drop it, all right?
Vito, there's something else. It's Mama.
What do you mean? What about her?
She's sick, Vito. She's been like this for weeks, and she's not getting any better.
Look, Frankie. Go to Joe's. He's holding on to my money for me. You get her the best doctor you can find. And, you keep the rest as a wedding gift.
Vito...
No, I mean it. Looks like I'm not gonna need it for a while. All right, looks like I gotta go. Look, you take care of Ma. Tell her I love her.
I will. And thanks, Vito. Bye.
Let's go, Scaletta. Those turlets ain't gonna clean themselves.